Alright, hello YouTube, welcome to my channel, Upstreet 412. We're taking you on a tour around the city, spots I know, spots I'm familiar with, perhaps some that I'm not familiar with. Today we're a couple days in to the Three Rivers Film Arts Festival. It's a Tuesday, so it should be way less crowded down here. A picture of the Fort Pitt Bridge, which will take you to the South Hills, the southern suburbs of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. So we're along the river here, just calibrating my camera. All right, let's walk around. Sunny day, about 90 degrees. They were calling for rain earlier, but it turned out to be a perfect day. So, good day to go out for a walk. Just got this gimbal. And so far, I'm really enjoying it. Very smooth. The purpose of this channel is for touring. Also, I find these walking videos to be very helpful for sleeping, for ASMR. I watch these at night, puts me right to sleep. Some of these I'll be filming with commentary, some without. This is the Monongahela. This is towards the point where three rivers converge, the Monongahela, the Allegheny, and the Ohio River. This is the considered the heart and soul of Pittsburgh right here. Point Fountain. Across the river, Heinz Field, Pittsburgh Steelers play. Still trying to figure out some of the modes on this. So, panning and tilting automatically. And this is the Ohio River to our left. And we'll be coming up to a series of bridges. Thank you. take a lot of these walks and bike rides for recreation and decided it'd be interesting to get a gimbal and make some tours. Videotape some, but I watch a lot of these online, like I said. And soon I'll be able to live stream these to YouTube. I just set up an account today, so it won't be live stream. I'll be using Prism to live stream to my YouTube channel. As it stands now, this is just a test of the new equipment. Even the phone's fairly new. iPhone 12. Just got the two camera option. Wasn't really sure if it was worth getting the third camera. It seems for my purposes two is enough, but I'm not sure what the third camera does, what kind of features it really has to make it that much better. I used to work and live, well, I used to work downtown for years. Let's go up here. And lived in numerous neighborhoods in the city, and now I am no longer in the city for, I guess for about 10 years I've been outside the city. Still come down there, down here every once in a while for recreation. It's nice. Nice parks. In my opinion, they've done a pretty good job keeping the city nice. Of course, the pandemic had a big negative effect on that, and we are about to have a new mayor soon. The old mayor, Bill Peduto, did not win re-election after 8 years. So we'll see what direction the city takes. I, for one, thought Peduto did an okay job. He gets a hard time for building all the bike lanes. As a cyclist, I'm biased in favor of bike lanes. I use them all the time. The bike infrastructure is pretty solid in Pittsburgh compared to what it used to be years ago. And I mean, the only people you saw on bikes were students and bike messengers. Now it's lots of boomers biking. All dressed up like Lance Armstrong, paunches, everything, just tight clothes. But it's pretty funny. But I'm happy to see that people are out enjoying it overall. All right, so we're gonna go walk. I believe this will take us into where the Arts Festival festivities are being held. We may even catch some live music. Side. Some good acoustics in this tunnel, if I remember correctly. Looks like not much is going on. It's Tuesday afternoon. This would be the stage where some of the main events would take place. There is another stage, I believe, around the other way. So we'll go ahead and walk that way. Maybe we'll catch the other smaller stage. heard that rollerblading and roller skating have kind of picked up in popularity during the pandemic. A lot of people finding activities to do outside rather than inside. And I heard there's a shortage of those items too, like a pair of rollerblades is pretty expensive on eBay these days. Including, I heard of a shortage of bicycle parts as well for the same reason. I know, being out and about on the bike during the pandemic, I noticed a lot more cyclists than usual. Stage I saw was through this one, I believe. I think this is one by the Gateway Center Plaza. Three Gateway Center Plaza. So maybe it is going to rain today. There's some dark clouds ahead, wind kicking up. They were calling for rain, and I was supposed to be working today, but called off due to rain. Little park here in the city. Good place to escape the sun, the heat. A lot of surrounded by a series of buildings. One, two, three Gateway Towers. Close this area and keeps the sun blocked out. So a good place to have lunch for people who are working downtown. Stage was. It doesn't look like they have it here today. I'm not sure how. This could be one of those virtual concerts, but I was down here on Saturday and they had music. Live music, some funk, a funk band. Pretty good. Had some good covers. Yeah, so there is another stage over here, but it doesn't look like anybody's playing today. There was a concert scheduled for one classical. See the stage. Nope. Nobody playing today. Had some good concerts over the years. Seen a lot of good concerts at the Three Rivers Arts Festival. Some like greats too. Kind of see across the way. It's the PNC Park. That's where the Pittsburgh Pirates play baseball. I see it in the trees. Tour of downtown. Some of these restaurants seem to be open for the most part. You know, some of them suffer due to the pandemic. This is probably after lunchtime downtown. Still pretty slow considering what downtown used to be. Sixth Street Bridge behind us, aka the Roberto Clemente Bridge. And here's an example of some of the bike lanes that have been put up in the past. It's probably been a good 5-6 years now, maybe longer actually. This lane has been at least 5 years, probably more. I want to say closer to 10 years. the Stanley Feeder. Might not be called the Stanley Feeder anymore though, but some great names have played here. This is actually the location of the last show of Bob Marley before his untimely death. I'd say like late 80s, played the Pittsburgh Stanley Feeder. And that was the last show he ever played. This is considered Pittsburgh's theater district. I have another theater over here to my left. Theater, it's a Greer Cabaret Theater. And then up here is another one. Okay, this looks like it says part of the Artist Market Arts Festival, so. Kind of. Locations around. Good fountain. Nice little park. There's Benedim Center. Another major theater. That's pretty much it for the theater district. Yeah.
What are you doing? Like, what's it for?
YouTube.
Oh, you got a YouTube page?
Yeah. Well, yeah. I'm starting one.
What's it gonna be called?
It's called Up Street 412.
You gonna be doing the streets?
Just walking
and
tours.
And you're gonna get big views on that.
I hope so.
Yeah, you will.
I watch them all the time. Like, there's one couple in New York City. I see. There's like one or two in Pittsburgh, but.
You gotta get the skyscrapers too, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
Man.
I figured the arts festival today is kind of walk around.
That's what's gonna do it.
Yeah.
The arts festival.
Yeah. All right, have a good one.
All right, you too, man.
A potential viewer, YouTube first video. YouTube's not even accepting my videos yet already. I was here years ago for steak. It was pretty good. Is it Liberty Avenue? Take a walk over to Market Square. Another Pittsburgh destination, but down here to Liberty Avenue. It runs parallel to Grant Street, which will be up ahead. One of the longer streets that run through downtown Pittsburgh. I hope he's right, man. Maybe I am gonna get a lot of views out of this. I know. This is people are waiting to see famous sports stars get autographs, sign memorabilia. Probably where sports figures and celebrities stay at this hotel. This is, I don't even know what this is. FL2, huh? Yeah, I wonder who's showing up today. I don't know, the Pirates are playing in town. Pirates are probably playing at home this week. All right, now we're entering Market Square. Lots of restaurants located down here, including some famous ones, the famous Primanti Brothers. It's directly across the square from us. Feels good to be back down in Pittsburgh. It's a lot of time. I used to work at this restaurant that's now NOLA. It used to be 1902 Tavern. The road closed over here. Makes it a little easier for pedestrians. If I remember correctly, this used to be a road that would pass straight through here. They turned it into a little bit of a park area. A game of cornhole. Colloquially called. And my Zoom doesn't want to work. Anyway, it's a nice Manny Brothers. Huge sandwiches. This is like, one sandwich is probably like 2,500 calories. Oh, they're so good. Famously with French fries and coleslaw on the sandwich. Nice fountain. Lots of nice fountains downtown. I've seen a few of them. This is the famous PPG Pittsburgh glass for PPG Place. You can see the building's entirely made of a glass facade with the kind of castle-like top. Practicing with my capabilities of this gimbal. Doing is wrapping back around to the point, back to the point, back to the epicenter, the heart and soul of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Arrived in Pittsburgh, I would say a few years back. Rentals, have not used one. They seem to be in okay condition. I noticed some people on them kind of maybe struggle with speed a little bit. Probably carries a little more weight than a regular bike. I'm sure it's aluminum. Another good example of some of the bike lanes installed. Yeah, man, these past couple years, pretty difficult. Downtown made a comeback. It used to be nothing downtown. Like, and I remember in the late 90s, even early 2000s, I mean, just office workers, basically. And a lot has taken place, and then the pandemic showed up and just gave it a massive sucker punch to the jaw. And we'll see how it bounces back. I mean, it seems kind of getting back to normal. I haven't really been spending too many evenings down here. That was a real thing after the, you know, everybody, office workers go home, are there people, you know, spending time recreationally downtown or not? That I'm not sure. To tell you the truth, I don't really come down here for recreation in the evening. I know I've heard there's been a little bit of an uptick in violent crime. Whether or not that has anything to do with the pandemic, I'm not sure. This station is fairly new. Gateway Station. This leads to the Port Authority T transit line. Kind of like our version of a subway. It's a nice station, pretty cool design. Center Plaza again. I showed you earlier in the video, so we basically did a big circle, a big loop through the city, and then we're headed back to the point. Example of bike lane. And you know what, overall, I'm happy for the bike lanes. A lot of Pittsburghers love to complain about the bike lanes, I guess. Little else to complain about. I mean, there are some noobs on bikes and it can be dangerous. There have been some fatalities in relation to more bikes being on the road. You know, a lot of people from outside the city coming into the city to use the bike lanes, and they'd be encountering some dangerous situations. Yeah, it seems like it's cooled down a little bit. Got some cloud coverage, so kind of nice, kind of turned out to be a nice day. It's probably like, what, 85 degrees? It's the Wyndham Grand Hotel. performing over the stage. That's where we end this walk for the day. So thanks for tuning in, and you'll be seeing more of me again up street 412. Please like and subscribe if you want to see more. Have a great week. Thanks. Bye.